McGregor, McDonald, McPherson, McLeod, McKenna, McLaren, McKenzie, Mackay, McIver, McEwen, McLachlan, Munro.
What do you got in the thermos, John? Tea.
Boys under 12, come and collect your money. Meantime, can we have some girls, 16 and under? Now, can we have some more ladies, please? There's a beautiful young lady here, with beautiful long hair. Yes, shoes, yes. Now, you must run after me seeing that. Come on, down you go.
Now, this is the most interesting of our Highland games. The object is to toss the caber so that it falls like the hands of a clock. That is, as close to high noon as possible. Now, that wasn't quite on. Now again. The contestant makes his run. There's his toss. And a perfect toss, McMoney, stout lad.
The Argyle and Sutherland are names of battles. Balaclava, Sevastopol, Lucknow, the Marne, the Somme and Mons, Malaya, Benghazi, El Alamein, the Rhine. This Britain, little body with a fighting heart, has castles strewn about like the bare bones of history. Many still the Britain's home. Dunvegan has been lived in for 750 continuous years, and the chieftain of Clan MacLeod will welcome your visit.
It was here that your forefathers and mine ate and drank together, listened to pipes, great pipe music of the MacCrimmon.
And as with Dunvegan, so with Howard, Powis in Wales, Windsor and Warwick. People live here. Here too. When a man is tired of London, he is tired of life. Dr. Johnson said it long ago, and it is true today. Don't try to gobble London down in one quick guidebook gulp. Savor it. Sit where Dr. Johnson sat and spoke of his London. Relish his then, before you return to your now. Be a Londoner yourself. Trafalgar Square can be yours, as well as Lord Nelson's. And Kensington Gardens Sunday afternoon are yours as much as theirs. Do be a Londoner. Learn to break the day for tea. This London, so familiar, yet so strange a mixture of the snug and the spacious, of the bright present, of the gilded past. Their playground, the stable of Buckingham Palace. Their coach, Her Majesty the Queen's. Once upon a century, long ago, another queen went this way to the Tower of London. Her name was Anne Boleyn. His was Henry VIII. In London, the past is always present. The trick is to catch them both off guard.
Blimey, if it was you or me late for parade, we'd be for it. Not half, we wouldn't.
A soldier's life is terrible hard. But in London, finding something to see, to do, to watch and wonder at is so easy. Just follow the parade. Join the sidewalk critics at an outdoor art show. Watch the sidewalks themselves on the Thames embankment.
All done by me own hand, ladies and gentlemen. All from memory by me own hand.
Cross to London's own left bank. Catch a Chelsea artist off her houseboat. Or see nature's own handiwork. Chelsea Gardens, brought to bloom by the greenest plums in the world. If it's flowers you've come to see, buy a program. People watching is free.
Why, Vicar, how nice of you to come.
My dear, your snapdragons won't do this year.
I'd have taken a first in roses if we hadn't let the head gardener go.
London. Her very pavements are like Britain's rivers. You've always known their names. Baker and Bond, Harley and Fleet, Oxford and Wimpole and Regent Street. But always when you see them, something new. Always something of yesterday, not wholly lost. Always that turn of the corner to the unexpected. Baker, Bond, Oxford, Fleet, no matter. You've always known this street.
First it was scourged by the plague. Then it was burned to the ground. And Sir Christopher came to the field of the fire and graced it with spire. A coronal cluster of steeples tall, and high over all, the cross and the ball, on the riding redoubtable dome of St. Paul.
The parade is always there to follow. You never know where it leads. Sometimes to a gilded then. Sometimes to a shiny now. Or, if you prefer, to treasure. At the flea market at Portobello.
I love it. I want it.
And speaking of his master's voice,
a really good sheep dog isn't hard to train at all, but the intelligence is there to start with.
The Britisher and his dog, inseparable. Be it blue ribbons in Hyde Park, or back to work on the Yorkshire moors.
Oh, sheep aren't stupid at all. I mean, You take winter time when the snow, when the snow's coming. If you watch the sheep on the moor, they'll tell you 4 days before when it's going to snow. It's a continual effort because the sheep are just as wise as the dogs. They keep manoeuvring around the walls and coming back to the farm again.
Rough wool, soft tweed, burnished saddle leather. Britain is a variety of textures. Thatch and whitewash. Timbers and brick. A meadow green, mountain blue, mist gray fabric whose shuttle is the endless road. Any road. Wherever he is, the Briton will stop to take tea. You can go on. Choose your stops according to your taste. For all you know, Mr. Pickwick may have been there before you. What makes the fabric called Britain? Where is it to be found? Down beside the sea at Brighton? Or the sunny beach at Blackpool? Along the swinging promenade at Scarborough? Or where all roads eventually lead, London? Many Britons, so many roads. Which is the right one? Which is real? The answer is simple. Wherever you are is only hours away. Come and find your own.